Right. I've been quite looking forward to this, so it better not be shite. Whenever it's finished load.
You give us 3 minutes and we give you the world. Good evening. I'm Casey Wong. A military submarine that went missing over 3 years ago has suddenly reappeared in the Baltic Sea. Confused seamen mistakenly opened fire on the last Lapland reservation, killing 12. Thankfully, our homesick sailors are back on U.S. soil. Welcome back, boys. In local news, a new crime wave that is sweeping Detroit has already claimed the lives of 21 police officers. Here's a statement from the head of OCP, Omni Consumer Products, that's funding and running the Detroit Police Department.
Old Detroit has a cancer, and that cancer is crime. It must be cut out, and OCP holds the scalpel.
According to our sources, the attacks were aimed at catching the attention of a man whose identity remains unknown. This dangerous new guy in town seems to have his eye on doing business in old Detroit.
Your filthy hands off me! Shut
up! I'm sorry. There seems to be a
disturbance? I'm a big fan. Now move! Don't adjust your television sets. Your regularly scheduled program will be back shortly. Now, this message goes out to the new guy in town. It seems that you're looking to spend some money in this great city of ours. I'm here to tell you that the Torchheads are open for business. You may have heard of us as the number one supplier of nuke in old Detroit. The most potent, addictive drug available in front of every convenience store, school, or library near you. But that's not all we're capable of. Let's get you up here. We'll get Officer Howard to illustrate the point. You see, Officer Howard made a drug bust that cost us a lot of money. We want to reward this dutiful officer with a performance bonus. A lifetime supply of nuke. Oh man, you're gonna have the time of your life. There you go. Enjoy. New guy, us Torchheads are more than capable of doing whatever you need done in our city. So what is it, huh? Arson, smuggling, drug dealing, good old-fashioned murder. We do it all. You've got the money. We've got the power. So let's talk.
Okay. The everlasting load screen.
Good to see you, Murphy. Lieutenant's at the main entrance to the TV station.
Hey, ground shaking. Judgment Day is here!
I mean, it looks quite good.
I can see your lady is still quite shaken up.
Thank you very much, mate, for 52 months. One of the longest guys that have been subbing apart from Valjoe. Thank you very much,
you
mate.
Know
appreciate
by now,
it.
When it comes to evidence, we're hoarders. If it keeps on like this, we're gonna run short.
Your move, creep. Thanks, man.
We can't wait any longer. Those trigger-happy maniacs have a ton of hostages. But, sir... Roger that. Over and out.
What is the situation?
Goddamn OCP tells us to stand down till SWAT arrives. That's our situation.
Looks like I'm on my way out.
Not so fast, buddy. Who do you think is gonna clean up this place? I'm not letting you off that easily.
You sound just like...
No, he does not.
If that's the case, let's get you patched up. We wouldn't want to get on her bad side. Press here. Medic?
This was a time before bullshit.
There you are, partner.
Lewis.
The hell is going on up there?
Sorry, dude! The police want us to release the hostages! So no hard feelings!
Hey! You can't go in yet! We need to wait for the reinforcements!
Reinforcements have arrived.
I knew you'd say something like that.
We need to find another way. It is too dangerous to cross.
For me. But you can take the heat. Go, I'll figure something out. Besides, you could do with a head start. Go on.
Dude, I remember playing Robocop back in the fucking, like, on the Amstrad CPC 464. When it was made by Ocean.
I've got a signet ring. How much do you think I can get for it?
Is it gold?
It was taken off someone famous. Just look at him. He looks kind of familiar.
Guys! We've got company. Anyone expecting a silver freak?
Drop it, scum.
Watch out! He's coming!
Oh, you get... Oh, that's fucking spot on, that. You got that iceberg!
Worried about the weight limit?
Lewis, you're here.
We need to get these elevators back online. The service box is in the basement.
Let me.
I doubt you had time between all the heroics, but I got a key card from the janitor. It's good to do some real street work from time to time, you know? After you.
Yeah, it does. It looks better than the version I used to play, like, in the Amstrad. So.
They obviously don't want to be disturbed.
That graffiti is fresh. I will keep them coming.
What a warm welcome, don't you think?
I guess I need to pick up all this stuff, but does it just get unlimited ammo? Like,
isn't it? Hey, why don't you check it out?
You can use Robocop vision to investigate options, objects, or people to find clues. Okay.
I am detecting a short circuit. We need to isolate the cables.
Fuck yes, good donkey. Just for that. It's a shame he's just got one big metal penis that he can do nothing with.
Thanks, but I'd say it was a team effort. They're holding everyone in the studio. It's on the 30th floor.
So, our friends in blue finally decided to join our glamorous show. I'm afraid you're too late for my autograph.
Chopper's ready.
I've gotta go, but the party goes on. Guys, make sure you provide all our guests with a decent amount of amusement, so don't skimp on the nuke. See ya.
Clang, clang, clang is a robot weenie.
What a freaking psycho. We need to be quick before they kill anyone else. I know that look, Murphy. You saw something, didn't you?
We are here to enforce the law, Lewis. Let us stay focused.
Right. Just keep
you know what would be cool? See if they made like a Judge Dredd version of this. That would be fucking awesome. I'm the law!
Bags detected.
Just look at that, boys! The police dog and its bitch!
Not sure which one is which.
You're gonna take that back.
Just look at it! How about I tell
you? Scumbag!
Strong antidepressants. When you face criminals who have taken hostages, you only have a few seconds to eliminate the threat. Alright, okay.
Thank God you've come! This lady really needs to see a doctor!
Murphy, these people need
what
help.
What about those big men?
I'll stay with them.
Right.
This is Lewis. We have rescued three hostages, one with a gunshot wound to the abdomen, requesting urgent medical assistance. Over.
Find and rescue the remaining hostages, okay. They must be the heavily armored guys. Seriously? Your move, creep. Pop your head off, creep. Well, if you look on Discord, you've seen that I have purchased said beers. Your face. Pop Donkey, you were already in it. Nice try, fuck all.
Dress. I'm not sure if I like the pattern. James really looks up to you. He said in school that he wants to be a police officer just like his dad.
My hands are shaking! Kill the hostages!
Mountain Man, how are you?
Hey! No sudden moves, cop! I'm not dying here! Get me another one of those choppers, like the one that took Soot! You hear me?
You work so hard, honey. Why don't you take some leave? We all could use a little break from this reality, don't you think?
Wakey wakey! I'm talking to you, Shiny! Stand back from that door, or I'll shoot her! I swear to Nuke!
I don't know what I would do if I ever lost you.
You got 3 seconds! Three!
Our family is the only thing I need to be happy.
Two! Are you fucking deaf?
Promise me, we will stay like this forever.
One! Last chance, weirdo!
Eat.
You okay there, Murphy?
I am a bit fucked up, Lewis.
What does it want? Get it away from me!
I am sorry.
Can you see? It's unstable!
Ma'am, please, calm down. It's been a very tough evening, and I assure you that everyone wants to be back home with their families. Though for some of us, the night has just begun.
Gone fucked up your fucking metal suit! Da, 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 da. Heron, you really shouldn't be looking at his ass. I mean, that's an issue.
Pay my bail now. cash.
Fucking right. No, do you know why? Because we had the good shit, Heisenberg.
Get back in line.
They're here.
Like, we had all the good stuff. The good cartoons, the good fucking movies, the good action heroes. So, yeah, why not fucking bring it back?
Tail between his legs.
Would have been nice if we caught him, though.
All right, all right. Are you done with this circle jerk, huh? Good. We've got a problem.
The malfunction caught on camera provokes a question. Can we put our safety into the hands of a machine? Especially one as unreliable as RoboCop. We asked Max Becker, the head of security concepts at OCP.
Now quiet!
We would never put a defective product on the streets. That's not what we do.
We all saw it hesitate in a life and death situation. Why? Does it really know right from wrong?
Listen, I would trust this guy with my kids. I mean, if I had any. This was just an isolated glitch. Thank you.
Mr. Becker, I've got more questions.
I just want to snap her little neck. But she's got a point.
This
was not an isolated incident. It's a pattern. A pattern that the old man wants examined and fixed. Time to see what's hiding in that metal head of yours.
We know what's in Murphy's head. It's what's in yours that worries us.
Push me, and you might just find out. You, follow me.
Everyone is dismissed. And Lewis, I need your report on the TV station incident. On the double.
On it, Sarge.
Hey, he's a fucking cyborg. He's not dead, you know.
Don't hold your breath.
Why is he fucking
looking to spend a dime?
Why is he wearing that fucking helmet?
There's my favorite walking, talking law enforcement machine. Okay, let's get on with it. Why don't you take a seat for me? That's a nasty scar. I'd like to see the other guy. Am I right?
You do not. Trust me.
Don't mind me. I'll just get this off.
So, here's the deal, Robo. The old man is not happy with your performance. Instead of sending you to the scrapyard, as I suggested, he wants to fix you. Hey, pretty boy. You sure know how to make an impression on the ladies.
Doesn't it hurt him?
Hurt? Lady, he's a machine. He's legally dead. We can do whatever we want with him.
No, madam. It does not hurt me physically.
So we're going to equip you with a little monitoring chip. It will do a real-time check of your systems so we can get to the bottom of what the hell is wrong with you. From now on, your performance will be monitored and graded. So better be on your best behavior, huh?
The chip is in. Let's see what we have here.
Right. All main. Right, okay. So I got 1,000 XP for that. Save none of the hostages! Fuck you. Each time you achieve a new level, you receive a skill point that can be used to develop your skills. Developing skills allows you to increase efficiency, obtain unique perks, and unlock favorable dialogue options. Okay. What do we want? How many points we got? We get 2 points, I think. Armor? And combat.
Well, I can already see some unwanted activity in your hippocampus. We'll have to keep an eye on it. Other than that, everything seems to be installed correctly. To be sure, let's make a simple test to check that all circuits are in order. What are your prime directives?
Serve the public trust. Protect the innocent. Uphold the law.
Okay, nothing disturbed. However, like with any new upgrade, I recommend visiting the range to check if you need calibration.
Is that everything?
Actually, no. Doctor?
Oh, yes, sorry. My name is Dr. Olivia Blanche. I'm a police psychologist. I specialize in dealing with police officers suffering from emotional trauma.
Emotional trauma?
I have an erection, Doctor.
Microwave. It hasn't been working properly either.
OCP wanted to see if you'd be willing to have a talk with me as part of your evaluation. I noticed that a great deal of care has been put into making sure that your mechanical components work. However, one aspect of your composition that has been severely neglected is your human side, your brain.
And your booby.
I agree. If it was up to me, I'd remove it altogether. What do you think, Doctor? Would save us a lot of hassle.
I don't mind the hassle. So what do you say, officer? Is that possibly something that could be of interest to you?
I am not sure.
Robo, Reed wants everyone in the briefing room in 5. It's about the new guy.
Excuse me, Dr. Blanche, but I am needed elsewhere.
But we...
Fuck off, woman!
Well, can't say we didn't.
Yes, it's the 80s where you can say fuck off, woman!
Man, I tell you, it was crazy in that TV station. Good job you had Murphy in with you. You bet. Without him, we'd all be gone.
I have man shit to do.
Murphy! Could you please help me out here?
What do you want, Reed?
What seems to be the problem, officer?
Reed is in the briefing room, and I have my hands full. There are so many complaints filing in that I can't keep up. It's getting crazy in here. Could you open up another line and help me?
I am here to serve the public trust.
Take the spot on the podium. You're a lifesaver, Robo.
This line is open. Please form an orderly queue.
Officer, I have a problem. My neighbors are hostile towards me. I think it's because they're jealous of my new dog. Why would they get so worked up every time I take him for a walk?
What is his name?
He has a beautiful red coat, so I call him Fire. He likes to hide, so sometimes I have to yell, Fire! Fire! To find him. Anyway. You do something about my neighbors.
Yes, a bit of a...
Your behavior disrupts public order. I must issue
a... Hey, ninja.
That's fine. I don't mind paying the price for having the cutest dog in all of Detroit.
Next, please.
I got something for you, officer.
I know where you can find a wanted criminal. That poster over there says there's a reward for that information. And I want it.
I want details.
Are you blind? I'm the guy from that poster, so here I am. Now, give me the money.
I will have to detain you.
Fine, but I still get the reward, right?
No.
You cops don't appreciate this.
Take him away. Next, please.
Officer, I would like to report my son missing.
How old is he?
He's 24, but he's never been gone for so long without letting me know.
How long has it been?
Just over 2 days now.
We do not consider an adult missing within 72 hours.
Oh, please, I'm begging you. Something's not right. You really need to find him.
What is his name and address?
George Elkins, 7706 Orchard Avenue.
Let me check. Your son was found dead 2 hours ago.
What? Oh, no.
Oh, your fucking son's dead. Fuck off. Bye. He's closed.
Thanks for the help, Murphy.
Yes. You're welcome.
There is no way. Murphy! I can deal with blood, guts, but puke is a no-go for me. Oh, be a sport and move his ass to the drunk tank for me. You've got your special gloves and extra protection, so you shouldn't mind. Just take him downstairs. I owe you one, Murphy. Oh no, the smell is following you. I'm gonna be sick.
I don't remember getting on a roller coaster.
Murphy, I heard you're scheduled for calibration. Step right up and press the button when you're ready.
I've got a fucking prisoner on my shoulder, for fuck's sake.
Look who's back home. Just toss him in one of the empty cells.
Finally.
Sleep tight.
Thank you.
me. How many fucking things do I need? Fucking shit!
Job. I'll let the eggheads know that you're good to go. See you in the briefing room.
So, what's on today's agenda?
It's no secret. The crime has been on the rise ever since what the media has named the new guy in town showed up in the city. The word on the street is that he wants to spend a lot of money in old Detroit, and that has made every gang in the city start advertising their services. We need to find him before
Holy
things get out of control.
Fucking bang on, the fucking sergeant.
Where do we look?
Our best bet is to see if he made contact with the torch heads.
Like for the movies?
Robo, I want you to start by checking the arcade downtown. It's become a high-activity area for punks.
Understood.
Everyone else, keep your eyes open. Any questions?
Any word on Briggs?
What happened to Briggs?
He's been missing since yesterday.
Shit.
Officer Briggs remains missing. That's over 24 hours since he's been in contact with anyone here.
Are the two cases connected?
No reason to assume so. But if anyone finds Briggs' informant, we might learn something new. All right, now get out there.
You go ahead, partner. I need to write this report, and there's something else I need to do first.
Sorry, Lewis, wasn't fucking paying attention to you.
Cruiser's ready for you, Robo. Go get him.
Have I got any fucking... Yeah, but overall, I'm not dead.
What seems to be the problem?
My damn locker won't open. Can you try? Wait, what is all this shit doing in my locker?
I want you to be safe out there.
Yeah, you guys, very fun.
Off we go.
came to clean up this city, didn't you? It'd be easier to burn it all to the ground. Believe me, just burn it all.
Could you please keep the noise down? You're scaring off my customers.
Can't hear you. Music's too loud.
Good evening. Are those two men bothering you?
First they harass my customers. Then they
let me shoot the radio. That's what would happen in the 80s. Just shoot the fucking radio.
What do you want, cop? Can't we have a little bit of fun? We did nothing wrong.
Your volume control seems to be broken.
Leave it! That's brand new! I've only stole...
Yes.
Thanks, officer.
You are welcome. Hello, homeless bum.
I always wanted to be a cop. I even applied to the academy, but it turns out that extensive criminal history and drug addiction prevent you getting in.
Hey. This area's off limits. You need permission to get in or a warrant.
It's fucking Robocop. You could just fucking punch the deck off him.
Something interesting in that barrel?
My sandwich fell in.
I have been dreaming of a hot meal, so here it is.
Hey,
hello.
I'll learn less if you hang around here.
Hello, prostitute. Can I give her a misdemeanor?
One that likes swimming in oil surely must be swimming in money.
Like it? What?
Was trying to steal my cart. Look what he's done!
Have I just wrecked your life savings? Tough shit, stinker.
Antisocial behavior towards a fellow citizen can be classified as a crime.
I don't know.
Lesson for the future. To save yourself the trouble. Clean up on the double.
You can't do it. I was only messing. I could have just picked it all up.
Hey, you tell him, robot man.
What a fucking joke.
What a fucking joke. What a fucking joke.
Mike was driving, and we heard what we thought was a blown tire, but it was just a gunshot.
Hello, biker scum.
And she takes off her top and says,
"Hey, this is a private conversation, pig.
I'll come back to you two."
See that guy down there? He's an asshole.
So why was that he come up here? Just so I could hear him say that guy's an asshole? If it got up here, there's another guy saying, "Oh, that guy's an asshole."
It's getting colder, and now we don't have anything for the fire!
How was I supposed to know someone would steal our old tires?
No, he could be having a few whiskeys. Fuck. Well, it's not fields of corn, is it? Chew on, Kate.
Oh, crap! Give me back my money, you piece of shit!
Don't you cops ever get bored with harassing successful entrepreneurs?
Hey!
I can guarantee you that isn't.
That's a serious accusation, kiddo. Someone might think I would allow such illegal activity in my high-class business, which I do not. I get lost.
You work for Soot. Tell me where to find him.
You cops are giving me a stomach ulcer. Stop asking me about guys I don't know.
Withholding information can lead to bigger trouble than a stomach ulcer.
Look, I'm a busy man, so I'm going back to my office now. Why don't you join me there, and we'll talk.
I've heard a bit man like you.
On second thought, you can't do that, because you don't have a warrant, do you?
What a douchebag.
Alright, bear with me. I'm gonna go grab a drink. I'll be right back. 2 seconds. Talk amongst yourselves. That's my cocktail. Heisenberg, thank you very much. Masturbation, irrelevant to the case.
Oh, I didn't know you had such amazing colors. And there's not one, but two of...
Your body readings suggest substance misuse.
Oh, man, a real, like, TJ laser? You are so incredibly shiny. I'm definitely getting more of this stuff.
Who sold you drugs?
I really shouldn't say, but you are my TV hero, so... All right. All of the arcade staff will sell to you. As long as you got cash. Unfortunately, I'm broke. But I have a great idea. You could help me sneak into the basement. They keep a huge stash of goodies down there.
Drugs in the basement? I will take care of that.
Would you really do that for me? Way to go, TJ! Is that the ocean?
Open the door. I have the warrant.
Oopsie. I think I dropped my key somewhere. You'd have to break down this hardened door if you want to get in.
Okay. That will not be a problem.
It's RoboCop!
Surrender your weapons.
No chance! Light him up!
You're gonna die here!
The ability to grab things is fucking hilarious.
Open the door, or you will regret it.
Can't a guy just sell drugs to kids without you harassing him every 5 minutes? Who am I hurting, huh? They all want it.
Where do I find Soot?
Well, if that's the case...
Shut it, bozo! Unless you want to end up in the ghost house like that cop's informant!
And don't you dare open that door, I'll shoot you!
Have it your way.
Too many cops patrolling the place. Don't leave before the police informant talks. Detox made the snitch too weak. Use tainted nuke to crank him up. Ghost house down the street next to the train tracks. Absolutely never in a fucking million years, Brandon. Absolutely fucking never. If someone buys me the Call of Duty, then I'll play it. If you think I'm spending money on it, you can all suck a dick.
Top of your priority list. You can start by asking about it at some of the local garages.
For the record, it's a blue SUX 6000, registered to Melissa Kuzak.
Hey, me found my guarantee.
What?
Someone knocked out his teeth, including the gold one. He's asking if anyone found it.
For some to learn how not to lose the track of time is to learn how not to lose their money.
Well, well, well. What do we have here?
Citizen, I'm ordering you to discontinue this deliberate act of vandalism.
Screw you, man!
You ever seen Robocop run, mate? Right? Mm-hmm. I wonder where he is, boys.
So, what you gonna do? You can't put me behind bars. I'm still a kid and only done it once. Just let me off with a warning, will ya?
I hereby assign you 40 hours of community service.
Doing what?
Painting over the illegal graphics.
You're telling me I'll get to cap over tags of those assholes from the hood with police watching my back? Sweet!
Who's there?
Fuck up, you fucking drunk old bastard. They tell you that this is Robocop Scottish edition. Oh, my cherry. You mean I bought cherry flavoured drink? Alcoholic drink? Yes. As in, have I put my cherry... as in by setting my penis into a vagina, that's long gone.
Hey, I might be a little late filing my tax return, but sending a one-man army seems like an overreaction.
I am here to investigate the theft of a blue SUX 6000 that belongs to Melissa Kuzak.
Fancy car and fancy name, but I hardly ever get.
That's actually quite nice, to be honest.
Do you have any information about the whereabouts of this vehicle?
To be honest, I did some work on one of those cars recently, but I can assure you that it was not the one you're looking for.
Do I have your permission to search the shop?
I know what the world's like, but can a man go about his business without being harassed all the damn time?
Citizen, I would like to inform you that knowingly delaying an investigation is classified as a felony.
Yada, yada, yada. I don't have all day to listen, nor do I understand this bureaucratic jargon.
Would you like to call your lawyer and have him explain it to you?
You know what? If you really think you'll find evidence of that SUX ever being here, then be my guest.
Engineering level 2. How can you have engineering level 2, right? When... when you can't fucking unlock all that shit yet. Because it's the beginning of the game.
See, I've told you, you'll find Jack all, because there ain't nothing to be found. This place is legit.
I need access to one of your lockers.
I can't allow that. It's my worker's private possessions.
You said your shop has nothing to hide.
The locker you have in mind belongs to a boy named Scott. He works for me on and off. I have to admit, I had a tiny feeling he might have something to do with your case. I will open his locker for you, but I won't be held accountable for what's inside. That's his locker. Go on, have a look. And what do you reckon? Is he your man?
For the time being, where is the suspect?
You see, he hasn't turned up for work for some time. This morning, when two thugs swung by looking for him, I knew he must be in trouble. I've overheard him many times talking about a place where he does car jobs on the side.
Give me the precise location.
I can't tell you exactly where it is. All I know is that it's
just
one of the garages.
Tell me, Morgan Freeman.
Tell me why you think he is responsible.
He's young, bright, and would like to rule the world. I get it. But nearly every month he gets himself in trouble.
It is not enough to make assumptions.
I'm not a cop, but I've seen many things in my life, and where there's smoke, there's usually fire.
Is he a temporary worker?
You could say that. We fall out a lot because he brings a lot of hot stuff to the shop, and I'm not okay with it.
And you let him come back?
It's hard to make an honest living these days. That's why I understand his struggle, and I let him come back. Working here keeps him out of trouble. And to be frank, it's not easy to find such a good mechanic either.
Why did you cover for him?
I can't watch a decent kid like him get swallowed by this city. Don't look at me like that. Instead of giving him up, I was encouraging him to come clean. But a man can only try.
That is all for now.
Hey, make sure no harm comes his way. He might have done some foolish things in the past, but he's a good kid, and he deserves another chance.
A court of law, he does not. The judge of that.
Ah!
Oh God, I messed up good.
You must be Scott. What did you do with the blue SUX 6000 that you stole?
Hey, well, why would I have anything to do with that?
Just fucking tell me a little fucking prick.
You can't possibly help me. I don't want to cause any more trouble, especially for Ben.
Admitting to a crime is the best course of action for any young offender.
I can't go to juvie. Who's gonna fix this mess?
My duty is to serve the public trust.
Okay, okay. I admit, it was me who jacked the SUX. But he didn't leave me any choice.
Who is he?
I can't tell you. If he knew I gave him away, he'd take revenge on Ben. Oh God, it must be those thugs. We're dead. No one is going to save us.
If they are criminals, then they are the ones who need saving.
Hello? Anybody home? Where are you, Scotty boy? You can only hide for so... Oh, it's the metal pick.
Get shot in the balls.
You did it! They didn't think that through. Maybe you can put an end to this after all.
We shall find that out, Chudonkey. Good time.
To resolve this case.
I'll tell you what you want. Just please, help me fix this screw up.
Where is the car now?
Oh man. I'm sure it's still in their chop shop. It's a warehouse on the northeast side. The entrance is concealed, but I'm sure you'll find it. I'm no fighter, but if there is any other way, I would like to help. Maybe you need some more intel.
Who did you mean by him?
It's Rex, from the local gang. I only did petty jobs for him mostly, but this time he made me steal that car. He said he wanted the SUX 6000 we were repairing at Ben's. When I said it was too hot, he slashed me with his knife.
Why were you hiding?
You saw those thugs. They were looking for me. They realized I tricked them. They wanted the SUX 6000 from Ben's shop, but I didn't want to get him into trouble, so I stole a different one. I doubt anyone would have given a shit, but word on the street is that it belongs to the mayor's niece.
Any criminal matters should be reported to the police.
I know. I just thought I could figure this out by myself. Ben was right from the start. I shouldn't have gone down this road.
Tank Monkey, thank you very much for the tier 1 at 47 months. Cheers, buddy. I've been working, dude.
That is all.
Got to work. Now.
Proceeding to the vehicle's
no offense,
location.
But... streaming does not backup, pay the fucking the rent.
Negative. Threat calculation minimal.
You shut the fuck up, Tank Monkey Sim.
Evening, officer.
And who's a debt collector? Why can't I open the door for him? Dad, tell me the truth. Are we poor? Dad? Dad? I'm tired of your kids asking for
money. No, that's Sim. Find the way in. Well, it's not fucking startlingly obvious, is it? Well. Would you look at that? Look who showed up. You've been allowed on the internet? What's going on? Oh, you're waiting for the work thing? Almost like when a fucking that DJ's fucking guns. Except this has not been found in a fucking medium. Have that. Yeah, it's some Stardew Valley, really. Really? Oh, you don't want to play ships, dude. Don't lower yourself to ships. Oh, you don't have it installed? Probably wise. No, he plays Tarkov. It's shite. Baldur's Gate 3 is utter fucking gash.
Believe you've actually done it. Do you think I could take that car back to the owner and say I'm sorry? Maybe she won't press charges.
How very dare you.
His car is now in police
custody. It is utter waste, Gash.
Oh, please, I could really use a helping hand right now. Otherwise, I'm back in juvie.
I do not trust criminals. You will explain yourself in court.
I knew I had it coming.
He's not so dropped when he gets to jail, trust me. Can we get a shout out for Digital for old time's sake? Oh, tell people sub to you, you fucking loonball. You're making about fucking $20 a month off a million people that I forgot to unsub. In fact, you're not even sub to my channel, you little fucking American Floridian fucking wank. Too much money getting spent on fucking guns.
Oh shit, it's a metal freak.
You need to be talking.
No, you were gifted. You were gifted a sub. Talking. Need some fucking health. Is there no health in here? Aha! Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Energize the batteries. We have Duracell, which is far better. No. What am I meant to be looking at? Jump down the elevation. Nice move. Oh, well, he's over here now.
Are you the police informant? Do you know where I can find Soot?
Oh man, all great questions, but could you untie me first? They really outdid themselves with these knots.
Talk.
Hey, I don't know how you usually operate, but that type of information don't come free.
It is a privilege and a merit for civilians to assist the police in capturing wanted fugitives.
Well said. What can I say? I'm a sucker when it comes to helping the cops. So, it seems that the new guy saw the punks attack on the TV station and decided to meet with Soot on their turf. The meeting is supposed to take place tonight during Soot's concert.
Concert?
I know. I'm not really a fan of his music myself.
Fuck to the police.
But that's not what those shows are really about. Why don't we, get out of here, huh?
Lewis, Soot is meeting the new guy tonight at the old slaughterhouse.
Copy that. Pick me up at the station. I'll grab my gear. By the way, I've got something for you, Murphy.
They call me Pickles.
I don't care! I don't care if they're fucking calling you!
This one time, I saw Torchhead stealing a delivery truck.
Oh.
I went after them, hoping that a VCR would fall off the back of the truck, you know? But it turned out to be groceries.
I don't give a fuck! Listen to me, I don't care. Shut up.
Pickles. Still have a couple of jars laying around if you want them.
So you are an opportunist.
Hey, I prefer street entrepreneur. Know what they say, good business is where you find it.
I'd like to, but the game doesn't allow it. As in, he's part of the storyline. RoboCop does not run.
Thanks, Tin Man.
And he's not fat, he's just metal boned.
Officer Briggs?
Yeah, he's my police go-to guy.
Officer Briggs is missing.
Missing? Shit. May our city have mercy on him.
How do you know Officer Briggs?
We go back a long way. He gave me a helping hand when I hit rock bottom. And I've been in his debt ever since. He even introduced me to his family. Great kid and wife, though his missus don't seem very fond of me.
You seem proficient in undertaking police tasks. Ever thought of making a living out of it?
Oh, no. One thing you should know about me, I love cops, you know, law enforcement, laws, all of that. I think those are great ideas. But so is Nuke, and when I need it, I tend to forget about the other stuff. So, you know what they say, you can only serve one master.
Do you think Briggs is in trouble?
I really don't know. Last time I saw him, he was going to check a case of missing bodies. Sounded like a bogus lead, so I didn't press it. Funny enough. He always tells me to be careful when getting info. But the truth is, I'm not the one running around gangster's paradise.
On Ute Lawn.
Need to go. Duty awaits.
About that. I've got a favor to ask. I know that Briggs is missing, but I've got something that belongs to him. He must have misplaced it the last time he visited my crib. And it's kind of weighing me down.
What is it?
It's his wristwatch. Now, I feel bad holding on to it. Could you please give it back to his family?
This is stolen property, and you expect me to return it?
Gee, that sounds bad when you say it like that, but still, you shouldn't let me hold on to expensive things. That's how I ended up in this situation in the first place.
I will make sure they receive it from the repentant thief.
Oh, boy. You're a tough negotiator. But surely you don't mean now. I gotta chillax after all this.
We will proceed with haste.
Oh, for God's sakes, man. As you command, Officer Steely. Hey, Tin Man, over here. This is where Briggs lives. Let's get this over with. His watch is burning a hole in my pocket. Apartment 21. Oh man, my hands are sweaty.
Are you going into a drug-related withdrawal? Do you require medical assistance?
What? No, I'm just nervous. Me and Gail have a complicated relationship. She's good at reading people, and I'm the type of person that doesn't like to be read. I know that inevitably I'll do something she doesn't approve of.
Like steal a watch?
Like steal a watch. it. Deep breath. Let's do this. You first.
Robocop? Are you here about Mike?
Yes, I am sorry to hear about your husband.
Oh, Gail. No. This junkie is not coming inside. What else are you gonna steal?
Funny you should say that.
I can't stand him. I'm sure he has something to do with Mike being missing. Are you any closer to finding my husband?
We are still looking. Is there anything more that you can tell me about his disappearance?
Mike, hun.
I've already reported what I know, but if you have any more questions, shoot.
I heard that he was looking into reports of bodies going missing.
An old lady approached him at the precinct and told him a sob story about how she couldn't afford to bury her husband. Can you believe that? Anyway, when she finally collected enough money and went back to the morgue, only to find that they had lost her husband's body, Mike went to check it out and never came back.
They're not gonna kiss his fucking Robocop, you dick.
Where was the last location that he was seen?
I remember him telling me that he was leaving his jurisdiction, that that's where the leads were taking him. I tried to convince him not to go. It seemed dangerous, but he felt sorry for that old lady. He went against his own rules and me. He left angry because we'd been arguing.
Do you remember the exact location?
He never told me, but maybe it's in his files.
Why do you think that Pickles is involved in your husband's disappearance?
My husband's a good man. Sometimes too good for his
own. His mouth is showing.
He believes in second chances, even if someone doesn't deserve them.
Like Pickles.
That unappreciative asshole constantly gets himself into trouble. I mean, who's always there to get him out? You guessed it. Salt of the earth, Mike. Pickles has a bad influence on my husband.
I think I have everything I need for now.
Knowing you're on the case makes me a little less anxious, Robocop. Now I just need to break it down for our son.
He does not know?
I didn't know how to tell him. He's a smart kid, and I think he suspects something. Could you maybe tell him to come home? It's getting late, and the streets aren't safe these days. He normally dawdles, but having you tell him should light a fire in his britches.
I will make sure that he returns home, madam.
Thank you. He's playing on the basketball court nearby with his friends.
That went pretty much as expected.
We are not done.
We're not?
You still have that watch, do you not? There is someone who needs to learn what time it is.
Is that a movie quote?
The big robo-penis.
We must get to the basketball court.
Think he's got 20 seconds to comply?
It's got to do with time. Is it like time to kick my ass?
We are going to remind Gail's son that it is past curfew.
Oh, Daniel. Sure.
Good evening, citizens. I need...
Need what? Some spare parts? Hey, there's a mechanic up the road.
We all have to obey the rules of the games we play. Unsportsmanlike conduct makes all players look bad.
That's right, fool. That was a technical foul. I didn't know he's so delicate.
What do you need?
We're looking for a kid. His name's Daniel. He was playing here earlier.
Why? Is it past his bedtime?
It is.
Yeah, I saw a couple of kids drawing with chalk they found lying around that crime scene over there.
Thank you for the information.
Congrats, guys. You just became police informants. It has its perks. You'll love it. I see a couple of drawings over there.
This was drawn not long ago.
Ah, there's more over there. Oh man, are we really jaywalking? That's $100 fine. Huh. I guess we're conducting an investigation.
Daniel! Come on, kid! Where are you?
You should be somewhere around.
Shoe print, size 7.
That's gotta be his. Over there.
No, it is locked. They did not go inside.
Look at my wee pickles.
They threw out the chalk here.
Must have found something more interesting.
You're not a man of color.
What the fuck?
That was close.
We better hurry.
Do it. Come on. End him.
What are you waiting for? Fuck him up. He's laughing at you.
Hey, what the hell's going on over there? Yo! Daniel!
Oh no, it's the cops!
I don't want to go to jail for this shit!
Is that a gun? Oh, you're in so much trouble, kid.
No, it's not.
Whoa! What the hell? You're lucky that Tin Man here doesn't have a real heart. He'd have a hole in it right about now.
Sorry, sir.
You will be once your dad hears about this.
My dad's missing, so he can't tell me nothing. My mom said that he's out on an assignment, but I know the truth. He's not coming back.
Why'd you say that?
He's always been a stickler for following the rules. I guess that's why he's missing. Cops can't shoot without giving a warning, and someone got the drop on him. But that's not gonna happen to me. I'm going to be the one that shoots first. That's why my friends say...
Your friends are knuckleheads. If you listen to them, you're a knucklehead too. Come on. Sit down. We need to talk. Those friends of yours, they take the easy way out. You don't want to go down that road. It leads to a dark, lonely place. Do you know why your dad is such a stickler for the rules?
Because he's a chump.
Because it's the right thing to do.
No, you little shit!
It's easy to do the right thing. It takes strength.
And you think my dad has that kind of strength?
Are you kidding me? Your father has enough strength for the both of us. He even helped an ungrateful addict that he found in one of these buildings that smelled of rotting garbage, half dead and covered in vomit. And instead of writing him off, your father opened his home malarkey, to him because
really?
That was the right thing to
That's
do.
That's a bunch That's of malarkey.
Don't you think there's someone else who could use that kind of support now?
Mom.
See, you already know what to do. You can start by giving her this. She's looking for it.
Is he going to arrest me?
No, it's your first offense. So he'll
want a bit
off with a warning, right?
Right.
It's late. Let's get you home.
Well, you tell my mom about the gun?
No, she doesn't like me already.
I'm sorry, but the kid needs to be arrested.
Thanks for the help, Tin Man. I'll talk to you later.
Hey, partner. What's the status on the old slaughterhouse?
I had to take care of something. We can go there soon.
Sure thing. Pick me up at the station when you're done.
Tank Monkey, thank you very much for making Jeff Bezos very rich again. Cheers, buddy. More cock rockets to space, indeed. Want him shot oin space? Oin space? Interesting choice of language. I know. Of course I know. What secondary objective? No, paying for a ticket.
One parking ticket is all it takes to improve my business.
No, I think they've got to be scumbags that are interactable with. So I've still got two tickets to give out.
Can you help me out here?
Be a man, Pig. Why make such a big deal?
How can I assist you, officer?
I'm trying to catch this one shifty dealer. This guy steals nuke from other pushers to sell it at half price. This dopehead buys from him but won't tell me his whereabouts.
I don't know any dealer.
You were carrying for three different pushers, so you either like to walk for miles to buy nuke, or you appreciate a discount.
Don't take it out on me, because the guy broke your nose.
As you can see, he doesn't want to cooperate.
Do not worry. According to my directives, there are several ways to convince him to cooperate.
I ain't gonna let it reprogram my brain. We can talk, but don't let it drill into my head, okay? The guy's name's Maurice, but I don't know where to find him. I always arrange a place over a payphone. I'll give you the number.
Let's hope it works. The dealer knows where the others hide their stash. We could collect nuke from the whole neighborhood if we get to him.
I will take care of it.
But you need to find a payphone first. Try near the supermarket. I think at least one of them hasn't been smashed by vandals yet.
Nice shiny armor, officer. Wanna be my knight?
Find a working phone booth. Hey, banana. Yeah, you're not allowed in America, mate. You know this tank.
Maurice?
Listen, man, I'm really swamped with the laundry right now, so make it quick.
So you would not want to earn some money, would you?
I don't! I mean, I do! I do want to earn money! But wait! Your voice. You sound like...
a future happy customer.
Fucking RoboCop! You want to bust me? Why don't you do a better job of finding guys who vandalized phone booths? I'm losing customers because they can't find working payphone in this goddamn... What the fuck is it this time?
Anybody home? Don't hide, Maurice. It's just a friendly visit. You like to do laundry? You should try working at the laundromat instead of violating the basic rules.
RoboCop, you have to help me! The back of the red building by the supermarket, apartment 6! There's some guys here! I think they mean business! Hurry!
He's on the phone!
I'm telling you, officer, dumpsters are like a bag of candies. You never know what you're gonna get.
You're going to live in Chudonkey's. Chudonkey doesn't have a cornfield.
I hear footsteps. If someone starts shooting again, make sure the kids hide under the bed.
You may regret that.
Listen, guys, I'll never touch your stuff again. I swear.
That's not why we're here.
So what do you want? The money? I have your money.
You only have half of it, and that's the problem.
You're selling our product at half price. That makes my customers complain about my prices.
It ain't nice, Maurice.
Maybe you think that building a customer base by selling your product under its manufacturing cost is a good idea.
An inflatable shit.
But it's not. Cool. Such practices are spoiling the market.
It's been proven time and time again.
I'm not saying that Tank Monkey looks like a shit when he gets into a pool, but you know.
Antitrust laws are there for a reason.
Shit, Maurice. All we want to say is that you violate the basic rules of the market with your predatory pricing. We can't just go along with that.
It's unfair and unethical.
Not to mention illegal.
The fuck?
You are under arrest. Come quietly, or this may be the last economics discussion you will ever have.
Get him!
Oh, shit, man! Why did you do that? What am I gonna sell now?
There are serious charges against you, Maurice. However, you can hope for a reduced sentence if you reveal where these three dealers keep their drugs.
Or I can jump into that pile of garbage below. A few bruises is better than jail.
Do you know what the likelihood is of surviving that?
I know the hood better than you do, cop. So try some different talk, or I'll jump.
You can die. The likelihood that the jump will not be fatal is 9%.
And that was supposed to convince me? 9 out of 10 is almost a sure thing! See ya!
Maurice did not trust you.
Heard your daughter was promoted to executive, huh? Why not ask her for help?
I'd rather ask the devil. My daughter is called.
Really? There's nothing. He's just standing here like a freak. There's gonna be somebody doing violations here. Come on. It's a crime ridden city. Scotland is fucking Barbados compared to where you used to. Be fucked if I know where anything else is happening. Since I don't have a map. That's Edinburgh, that doesn't count. I'll be fucked if I can find anybody else committing crime. There is no clues. It's a secondary mission, Tank. Can you explain things to your fucking drunken mind?
Littering is prohibited.
What was I supposed to do? I've missed the garbage collection and we had fish on Friday.
You have no idea how much it reeks.
You violated the law.
Oh, man. So I pay the city for not removing my garbage, and now I have to pay for removing it myself? That's ridiculous.
The moral is, stay away from fishy activity.
Fishy activity? Mississippi, how are you?
Hey, Robo! Saw you on the TV! Come here! I haven't congratulated you yet.
I'm doing alright, mate.
My favorite TV star.
Days off.
Thanks to you, Kurt's finally had a reason to watch something other than the fast food channel.
I was merely doing my duty. That kind of hostile situation is not the only thing I can resolve. Can you tell me what happened here?
Nasty murder. The victim is a white female, mid-20s, identified as Casey Carmel. Had a history of petty crime and prostitution, but believe it or not, that's her real name.
Any leads?
The case is closed. OCP won't spend a single dime on the murder of a prostitute.
Cost optimization. Fancy name for we don't give a shit about poor people.
So if you were to look around the crime scene, you would potentially be exposing OCP to extra costs.
If you want to do that, be our guest.
Is that homeless man considered a suspect?
Nah, we know the guy. You can rule him out.
The guy's a loon, a mental patient. He thinks that aliens dumped a body here.
Talk to him if you want. Just prepare to hear a tall tale about green people.
Do you have any thoughts about that murder?
I'd bet the girl was killed somewhere else, and the body was only dumped here. We got the tire tracks, drag marks. If we find a car that matches, we'll find our perp. Yeah, I guess the perp had his hands covered in some green-blue guacamole-ish goo. The body's covered in it.
Why does it always come back to food with you? Anyway, we need to do a proper analysis.
The best way to cut the costs of policing is to cut the criminals down.
Tell me about it. I didn't join the force to pick up dead bodies off the street.
Yeah, but what can we do?
I will look around. We must bring the murderer to justice.
Irrelevant. Relevant.
Poor Casey.
Custom extended wheelbase. Have you seen a vehicle like this around?
Nah. But that narrows it down significantly. Good catch, Robo. Somebody dumped her a few feet from here. The blood traces on the ground indicate she was dragged.
Okay, with a stick.
That's this green-blue shit under her arm. No idea what it might be, but there is more of it around. Nasty wound. Looks like she was hit with a blunt object, possibly a hammer. Her heels had to touch the ground when the body was dragged.
Yeah, it probably belonged to our victim. Let's try to find other clues.
Oh, I can help you find the guy who dumped the body here. I saw him, but you must accept the truth.
Tell me what you know.
It's as simple as it gets. Aliens did it.
Aliens?
I've been investigating them for years. They send rats to spy on me. They don't want me to show you this list. It's a list of aliens living in Detroit. All 37,617 of them. The murderer included.
Most likely a van with a custom extended wheelbase. Does your list contain any information on such a vehicle?
Jackpot! I've got a guy with a van that matches your description. I don't know his ID, but I know where you can find him. A film set near the courthouse. They're shooting a TV commercial and it's run by aliens, so it all makes sense.
Wow.
Casey must have discovered something there, and they got her. That must have been what's happened.
Why do you think that aliens are involved?
I saw the guy who dumped the body here. I saw his skin. It was green and glowing like those toy dinosaurs that children play with, and years later develop serious diseases from.
Why do you think that aliens run the set?
Who do you think runs the advertising business? They're stuffing commercials with subliminal messages. They use additional film frames with commands to make us obey. Don't you know what happens to those who watch TV?
What is the purpose of your list?
It's my tool to spread the truth. I update it every month and add it to my newsletter. You should read it. It's free. You'll find out some stuff.
Time for RoboCop to show him his fucking weapon.
Like what?
Take the moon landing, for example. Didn't happen. Why?
Moon landing?
Because the moon doesn't exist. First time hearing about it? That's why you need my newsletter.
I will verify your statement. Nevertheless, I recommend you consult a psychiatrist at the earliest possible time. Now, the set. What is happening here?
They're shooting a TV commercial for Sunblock 5000.
Night does not seem an appropriate time for such practice.
Yeah, they ran into some problems, and it's running later than expected.
I swear, we're staying here until we finish, or you're doing it without me!
Jerry, don't you think you're being unreasonable?
You better find us another understudy so we can get this over with!
Let him in. We don't want to hinder the work of law enforcement.
Get the fuck out of the way, dick.
I have reason to believe that someone from your crew is involved in a crime. We found a green-blue substance like your sunblock at the crime scene. The suspect was driving a van with a custom extended wheelbase.
We use a lot of different vans, but I would know if they're the type you're looking for.
In that case, I would like to look around.
Actually, you could be of some use to me, too. I have a problem here, and its name is Jerry. Jerry Jenkins. I need a reason to cancel his contract, and I think you could find one for me.
That does not sound like a task of a police officer.
Ah, but it could be, though. I'm sure he's guilty of something. You just have to find out what it is. I can give you access to anything without a warrant.
I can make trouble for anyone who deserves it.
I believe that. Dig deep. I bet Mr. Big Shot doesn't have a clear conscience. Start with the computer. There's a list of vehicles allowed to park on set there. But look for something on Jenkins, too.
The evidence I have gathered shows that you are connected to the investigation that I am conducting.
So what?
The perpetrator was someone with skin that seemed to be covered with sunblock. I saw the storyboard. You fit the description.
Nice try, but I won't even touch that toxic goo. I've got it in the contract. I use body doubles for all the shots where I'm supposedly covered with it. Wait, that bitch sent you after me, didn't she? She's looking for a way to screw me over and hide her incompetence. You want to investigate something, then ask her about the guy she hired as the understudy. His face looks like a walking mugshot. On top of that, I bet he's the one who stole my ring. See what she has to say about him, pal.
I spoke with Jenkins. He mentioned that you hired a criminal. This individual may be the perpetrator I am looking for.
You mean the understudy? Did Jenkins tell you that I hired him? He was the one who recommended him for the job. Don't believe me? Check the camera footage to see what good friends they are.
Why did you hire the understudy?
Jenkins' contract says he will not use sunblock, and none of the professional understudies wanted to do it either. They all say it's toxic. So I had no choice. Jenkins brought a guy and said he could do the job.
Where is the understudy now?
I have no idea. And that's the whole point. We can't keep shooting because he's disappeared. I hope the guy's in the hospital or worse, because if he's not, I'll kill him myself. It's a joke, of course. You understand jokes, don't you?
Show me the footage.
Check the camera footage.
Who are you, pal?
Your agent sent me. Special services. Pussies, man. I've got a place.
Of course, Mr. Jenkins, I'll take...
Take it and get lost! The smell of hard-boiled eggs mixing with this green shit makes me want to puke. Looking at your face doesn't help either.
You mentioned something about special services.
Only the best in Detroit.
I find that hard to believe.
I've got just the girl for you. Her name's Casey. She's...
No names.
Ah, Casey.
Your understudy offered you the services of a prostitute. She was likely the prostitute who was killed.
People offer me things all the time, but that doesn't mean I accept every one of them.
I have an offer for you. You can confess everything now, or you can get in trouble later.
Have you ever considered becoming a producer? You got a flair for it. You know what? Now that I think about it, why shouldn't I help the law enforcement of this here beautiful city?
Where can I find the understudy?
He works at a gas station nearby. But I don't think that's his main source of income.
I am not done with you yet. Do not leave the city.
Bitch. If I had my way, yes, I would definitely do that.
Sunblock is the least of your worries.
Look, I know why you're here, but I'm innocent! I swear!
You are being detained in connection with the murder of Casey Carmel. If you require medical attention, it will be given to you.
I didn't do it! Jenkins killed her! Jerry Jenkins, the guy from TV! You have to believe me!
You will make your statement at the station.
And you'll let Jenkins walk free! He's the one who killed Casey! They met here yesterday!
Casey's body was covered in sunblock. The evidence points to you.
I arranged the meeting, I admit, but I was gone when this happened. When I came back, she was already dead, and I decided to get rid of the body. Jenkins is the only one who could have done it!
Why would Jenkins be meeting a prostitute here when there is a motel across the street?
His agent got a hold of me and told me that the guy values his privacy. The money was good, and I was able to provide him with a discreet option.
He's blue, da ba dee ba da da
ba dee ba boo da. But when he saw Casey, he stopped being so picky.
Why would Jenkins kill that woman?
I don't know. I wasn't there.
Are you stalling?
She may have mentioned something about wanting to blackmail Jenkins, but I knocked the idea out of her head. At least I think I did.
Why did you not go to the police?
What would I say?
My smiling face.
The famous celebrity killed a street prostitute in the back of my gas station.
10 o'clock at night.
That's a bit much even for this city.
Last thing I wanted to do is set up a camera.
The dumpster seemed like a better idea to you.
It's not my fault that people would rather believe a guy from TV over me.
I will verify your version of events, but you will still suffer the consequences of the actions you have taken.
Hurry up, please! It burns!
Not spunk. But I still need to investigate this area. Or left to investigate. This better be good. That's a shite snuff movie.
Find anything?
According to the evidence, Jenkins is guilty of the murder of Casey Carmel.
I told you!
However, you are guilty of concealing a crime and desecration of a corpse. I will call medical assistance. You will be taken in when your condition permits.
Another person successfully fucking put in an ambulance by Robocop.
Let you in, Robo. They're in the middle of a shot.
This cannot wait.
They say that 20 seconds in the California sunshine is too much these days, ever since we lost the ozone layer.
I have a solution for you if you are looking for some protection against that California sunshine.
The hell?
A stay in Detroit prison. Jerry Jenkins, you are under arrest for the murder of Casey Carmel.
I've seen you on TV. You're glitching again. Ah, it hurts. For fuck's sake, it hurts.
They used the Robodick 3000 on the guy there.
This is where Soot is supposedly hiding.
Can't really call it hiding if he sent invitations to the whole city. A bit Rudy forgot about us.
At least I will not feel bad crashing his party.
Murphy, I was thinking about what happened to you at the TV station. Maybe you shouldn't...
No need for alarm. Becker's chip is keeping my circuits in check.
You're more than just circuits, Murphy. Underneath all that metal, there's still you.
Alex Murphy is gone. He lost his life.
And despite that burden, you carry on. You've done more for this city dead than anyone has alive. That has to count for something. I'm gonna shut up now. Just take this little something to remind you of what I've just said. Open it the next time Becker gets under your skin. Also, don't forget you have a partner who's counting on you.
And that is where we are going to leave it, boys, because it is fucking 10 o'clock at night. I've worked all day. I've had a 3-hour stream, so that's enough. I shall be back tomorrow. We might play ships. We might not. Who knows? Might play some rally. I don't know. Just need to wait and see. But thank you very much for the gift subs. Thanks very much for the resubs. I appreciate it. I've heard that about you, Brandon. But yeah, time for me to go watch a bit of television. Go fuck yourself, Tank. yeah, we might play ships tomorrow. You never know. You never know. Yeah, go fuck yourselves. All right. Thank you very much. Appreciate you as always. And I will catch you tomorrow. All right. So take care. Have a good one. And I'll see you tomorrow. Thanks again.